আমি ভাবছি যাক না কেন, ভাবনা কিছুই নাই, কলকাতা নয় দিল্লি যাবে কিংবা সে বোম্বাই। হঠাৎ কিসের আওয়াজ হলো, তন্দ্রা ভেঙে যায়, তাকিয়ে দেখি কলকাতা সেই আছে কলকাতায়। দ্য ওয়ান্স ইকোনমিক পলিটিক্যাল অ্যান্ড কালচারাল ক্যাপিটাল অফ ইন্ডিয়া, দিস সিটি অফ জয় ইজ দ্যাট এনিগমা ফ্রম ইয়র টেক্সট বুকস, ওয়ার কালচার অ্যান্ড হারমনি ইজ ইনফিউজড ইন দ্য ব্লাড। Here, you can be a Hindu celebrating Durga Puja and also choosing to enjoy a plate of biryani with your next door Muslim friend on Eid. You can be a Muslim and still go on to rejoice the sparkling Christmas at Park Street. Not to mention, people from all faiths are most welcomed in the Gurudwaras. If culture is the way of life, beliefs, customs and norms, art, then here it is. Every person an epitome of their culture. But again, with rapid technological advancements and increased exposure, this culture has only been ever-changing and ever-dynamic, giving way to newer aspects every passing day. Before India's independence in 1947, Calcutta was a pivotal center for the Britishers, with several trade centers, judicial and other administrative bodies situated there. This city was a pioneer of the nationalist movements that took place across the country, and various literary and artistic pursuits have been a part of this. All renowned eateries that we see today would once boom with the heated discussions of our freedom fighters. It was around this time that the blending of Eastern and Western cultural influences also started, that led to the creation of many diverse organizations contributing to Calcutta's cultural life. Soon, with the country being independent, the struggle for power had begun. Trade unionism, labor strikes, and mass agitations had become common. People started moving in search of better jobs, and women started asserting their positions in the society. Needless to say, there was a rise in the standard of living, and thus emerged Bangali Bhadrabhumi. Things like theatre, cinema and fine arts had become a part of the Calcuttan culture, and the intellectual middle class took pride in the works of the legends Satyajit Ray, Mrinal Sen, Hrithik Ghatak and others. The nightlife culture in the 1960s was also an integral part of the sophisticated elites. Cultured men and women from the upper reaches would sweep down Park Street in their swanky cars and dance to the music of live bands at Trinkas, Mokambo, Mola Rouge and other restaurants of those times. The IT revolution that followed alongside Calcutta's throbbing industrialization changed a lot. A more formal 9-to-5 culture, mall culture and party culture, among the others, started to come up. Alongside the disappearance of telegrams and telephones, radios and television started becoming an integral part in the lives of Calcuttans who were avid listeners of news and sports. Speaking of which, the already existing rivalry between East Bengal and Mohunbagan seemed to have intensified. The Boi Malas in the city quickly became a culture too, and the sheriffs, who although are on the brink of extinction, do still exist, making Calcutta the only city to have so. Now that was certainly a long way, isn't it? But what remained common was the adda, the chai conversations, simple smiling people reading the newspaper, Rabindra Sangeet, Virendra Krishna Bhadra's Mohishashur Mordini, Pujo shopping, the iconic Shondesh, the iconic trams, and the list can go on. These don't seem to go away. After all, the culture is deep-rooted. And so, if one has to explore India, you know where to start from. Kolkata, the cultural capital of India.